So, a company called Mastering the Mix released a new plugin today, which is kind of weird. I mean, today is a day that is all about, well, for me, Apple, because Apple is about to announce new products. And that will probably be an Apple Silicon MacBook or whatever. I'm pretty stoked for that and not really stoked for other products. So it's weird to release a product for the audio community at a day that a part of that audio community is actually watching something else. But anyway, I'm still trying to get some views here. And I might try to catch some views later with my thoughts on the new Apple products, because for studio use, it's actually very interesting. It's a very interesting discussion. But that's not what this video is about. This video is about the reference plugin from Mastering Mix. It's actually Reference 2, so it's an upgrade. I've never seen the original one. I've never tried the original one. So I'm just going to do this like a full video, maybe showing a lot of features that were already in there. So yeah, let's get started. Reference, mixing and mastering utility plugin. Well, that sounds good already. No big bald claims, just mixing and mastering utility plugin. It can be frustrating not knowing exactly how to get your music comparable to your favorite mixes. Reference is packed with powerful tools and insights to help you get closer than ever to the sound of your favorite music. Of course, your favorite music should be in the same genre as the music that you are making. Using ABBA as a reference on a dance record might not be a good idea. There could be a lot of crossovers between dance music and ABBA, for instance, but not from an engineering point of view. Like, the whole EQ curve and the dynamics is completely different. All right, so there's a video which completely demonstrates the plugin. Not going to watch that. And I will get roasted again about that in the comments, but it shows a lot about the user interface. If you immediately understand it or can easily figure it out, I mean, some features are more complex, but if it's easy to figure a feature out, it says a lot about the user interface. All right, key benefits. Compare your mix and master up to 12 reference tracks and create multiple loops so you can quickly compare various sections of your track to your reference. Okay, so 12 reference tracks. I wonder how that works. Like, can you switch it? Like what I see in a plugin is tabs? Or does it take an average from all those tracks together? Because if there's one thing that I know is that you can have too many references. I always say like maximum of 3 references, because otherwise you are constantly switching. Let's say you've got reference track 1. You make it completely like that one. You compare it and you make it. And then you're going to the second one. Then you have to change it again. You go to the third one. You have to change it again. Because every track sounds different. That's the issue. You run through all those 12 reference tracks. You go back to the first one. And you can start all over again. Because then your song doesn't sound like the first reference track anymore. So it's good to make that smaller. They've chosen to give you a maximum of 12. I think that's already too much, like 2, 3, 4, like the complete maximum. Or what would be really cool if they have built in like something to average, like get an average of all those tracks. That would be the best, actually. Instantly and accurately match the loudness of your track and your references. This is crucial for fair comparison and for making informed decisions on how to shape your sound. Yeah, that is. Loudness is super important when comparing from multiple ways. Of course, if you're level comparing, you have to match your loudness. If you are like A-B testing, if the reference track is louder or your track is louder, it's automatically better. That's how our brains work. There's nothing you can do about it. I mean, in the end, we are still cavemen. So yeah, or cave women. Visual and actionable insights to make matching the true peak, loudness, EQ, balance, punch, and stereo width. That's a lot of stuff actually. So it's true peak. Yeah, okay. Loudness, that's important. EQ balance is important. Punch, I don't fully understand what they mean with that. And stereo width. So that's all the things that that's actually a lot of important stuff when you want to, you know, reference. Includes an additional source plugin called RefSend that allows you to bypass entire FX chain to make loudness matched A-B comparisons. But you want to have the whole FX chain on it, right? I mean, we're talking about end products. We're talking about like more mastering stuff, right? Or well, let's just take a look at the plugin. And this is it. Of course, in the spiffy interface that we are used to for mastering the mix, although this looks a bit more functional. Although it doesn't do a lot yet, but that's logical, of course. Oh, whoa, 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 whoa. Whoa, Okay. We first have to drop files here. So let's do that. Let's get some stuff in there. And then run my favorite track to it for testing this stuff. That is, of course, a track from Darude, Sandstorm. I have to fall back to you. Wait a second. It's referencing it.
Wait.
So it's just playing it back inside of here and then analyzing it. So I should put it here. Because wait. This drop and this drop. Okay. Doesn't make a lot of sense, but now I can make a loop, so I can say like, okay. Now it's constantly looping this, and I should also loop over here. That's weird. That's weird because you actually want to like select this, like okay, say like okay, this is the part that I want to reference. And you wanted to calculate an average of that. No, not this part. And maybe also this part. And then like add it up to each other. And then when we're working on the break, select the break. And then get an average of the break. And compare that average of what is going on here. Because there should be some red line through it. Like there should be something, some general. Of course it's bouncing up and down. It's music. But they should be able to get like a fingerprint from that. What if I... Like, so what is this thing saying? Ah, cool. And I can listen to my low end. Oh, compare it. This is only... So what it's now saying is that I have too much 100 Hertz. Alright, so now I have an EQ and I should be... What should it be? It's also weird that it's not holding. It's not holding the pad. It's completely going back. Like when I press stop, it should hold. So that I know the thing that I've last seen. Okay, I'm missing some 100. Oh! Already going... Oh, wait. Other side. Is that it? Huh? Ah, my levels are changed. Oh, so it's dynamically and automatically changing the levels. It's actually dangerous if you keep it turned on your master bus. You should make sure that you turn it up. Anyway, so 100 was a problem. Not anymore. We need a little bit more low, like a shelf, so we should do this. It's actually cool feedback. It's really giving you feedback. It's not automatically doing anything, and I like that. All right, now we have to wait, I think, for the loudness optimization. Wait. A little bit lower here. And then between 1 and 2K. We're here, a little bit smaller, Q. When do we get this low? You guys also hear that this is not going to be the other record. It's never going to happen. But still, I want to see what information can we get. All right, Trinity display, punch dots, okay. Punch dots. Let's only... Okay, so this is where the rest of my information is. I was already wondering where it is. Punch dots. Okay, punch dots. It's showing... This is weird. And I like actually that mastering the mix is really about you know, searching for new ways to control things. What they do with the base room stuff is, I don't like it, but I like the courage that they have. And here again, like, I'm not even getting it, but I think what it's saying is like, hey, here is some punch and here is some other punch. Here's, yeah, this is probably the hi-hat. I think punch is really difficult to really define. Not sure what to do with those dots. Probably the manual will say it, but am I really going to read it? These are things that you could also like pretty easily hear. I mean, super easy to hear. Yeah, I think it's super easy to hear. Stereo width, all right. So this means that I should go wide. I can do that here with just a side EQ on a high shelf. Should I be higher, wider, or should I be less wide? I should be less wide, I think. Yeah. Ah, cool. All right, so the plugin on itself, it works, and I think it's most of all the lower part of this plugin is really cool. I think that the upper part's really there for, you know, just workflow and ease of use, because one of these tabs could be that ref send, and then it's actually just a channel from your DAW, works. I think it's the same as sidechaining it into the plugin, but then in this case you just add a separate plugin, which is, I think, always easier than sidechaining it. This lower display is what you really want and what you really need. It's a comparison of two sounds, and you want to know, like, okay, where are the differences and where are the big differences. There are a lot of issues with this type of comparing. I mean, tonality of the kick, if your kick is in a different tone, then of course it's going to say that there's more 60 hertz because your track has more 50 hertz, like all that kind of stuff, and you see that they're doing some averaging and stuff, but you really have to understand those mechanics in order to use this and not be fooled by it. I already see a lot of beginners, most of all, really draw out the whole curve that this thing is giving in FabFilter, which FabFilter can also do itself, by the way. But you can draw out the curve that it's giving you over here, and that is not really going to give you that great sound, because in the end it's not about sounding like someone else. It's about making a great sound on its own, and you can use someone else as inspiration. That's what this thing is doing. But there are a lot of things that could be better that I would really like to have in such a plugin. One of those things is really averaging things. Like, okay, give me that whole drop, draw an average over it, and give me that as a curve. And if I import four different tracks, average them as well. Have that plugin with some AI wizardry, figure out what is going on in all of those tracks, what makes all of those tracks sound great. And again, if there's one kick at 40 and one kick at 60 and one kick at what the heck, 110, I don't care. Have that plugin figure that out and figure out that your kick is at 50. And then say, like, okay, so the other ones have the kick over here, or the low frequency punch, whatever, have that over here. But your track is on a different tonality or your kicks. So you have to boost or cut at 60 or wherever you are at. I don't even remember what I'm saying. So those are things that are really kind of missed opportunities, maybe. Because right now it's not like leaping ahead on other things. It's more of the same thing. Like, I'm pretty sure that there are more plugins like this in some shape or another. So yeah, I really like what they're trying to do here, but I would like to have more features in here. For me, I never use my own reference tracks. I have reference tracks from my clients. Clients send reference tracks with me. And this is sometimes also a discussion. Like, I'm emailing back to them like, hey, I don't think that this is a good reference for this song. And then we're looking further. Because that's already important. And if they have a good reference, what I always do is I actually have a button on my console. A separated reference button. Whenever I push that, I hear that reference track. And I, of course, align it in my session and make sure that the loudness is okay and that kind of stuff. But in general, I'm really using my ears. This is also something that you have to learn to trust. You have first have to learn, and then you have to learn to trust on that system. I don't do a lot of analysis. For dance music, I do look up on my analyze. I have certain thresholds on where there is enough low frequency information and that kind of stuff. And loudness analysis and that kind of stuff. I do not really with a comparison. I really do it because I know the values and I know like, okay, this looks good or this is within the boundaries. And I set them for myself in my head, knowing also what is coming out of my speakers. If there's piano music coming out of my speakers, the whole image that I have for what the value should be is completely different than when it's like a dance track. So yeah, and it's all relative. It's all kind of relative based on feeling. If it feels good, it sounds good, or if it sounds good, it feels good, or whatever was the quote again. Anyway, right now it's on sale for 49 euros. Normally it's 55.95. So 56. Check it out. I'll link to them below. Have some fun tonight if you are going to watch the Apple keynote. And as we all know, there are two types of people in the world. People that divide people into groups and people that don't. If you divide people into groups and do not like Apple or Apple keynotes, then don't watch it and watch more audio videos. I mean, why not? YouTube is full with it. Anyway, I want to thank you a lot for watching this video. If you want to be like me and dress like me, then that is possible by buying t-shirts. And when you buy those t-shirts, you cannot buy those vests, by the way. At least not from me. These are just like pretty standard, like fast. If you buy one of these t-shirts or other merch, a little bit gets sent back to me. It's pretty high quality stuff, so most of it goes to the manufacturing of it. But yeah, check it out, it's down below. Instead of being me, you can also support me, and that is possible by pledging a bit to my Patreon campaign, which I'm going to link over here. On Patreon, you get early access to videos and some other goodness, so check it out over here. Last way to support me is by watching and subscribing, so don't forget to subscribe. I'll link one of my videos over here so you can keep on watching. And from here, I want to thank you a lot for watching it till the end. Keep pushing and bye bye.